Good morning and happy Easter. Our opening hymn is number 172, Jesus Christ is Risen Today.
Good morning, good people, and happy Easter. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And your spirit.
And as we prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries on this Easter morning, let us acknowledge our sins, failures, and neglects, and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord. Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. You alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus.
Let us pray. O God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good in healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day, and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ your life appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Our Easter sequence is number 168.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the first day of the week, Mary Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning, while it was still dark, and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we do not know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial clothes there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial clothes there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial clothes, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture, that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
There is a lot of running in this morning's gospel reading. Mary Magdalene runs from the tomb to Simon Peter and to the other disciple that Jesus loved. They, in turn, run to the tomb together, with the beloved disciple running faster than Peter and reaching the tomb first. They ran because the tomb in which Jesus had been buried was now empty. Initially, the disciples did not seem to know whether the surprising discovering of the empty tomb was good news or bad news. Mary Magdalene said, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb." She thought the body had been stolen. The initial running was in the energy of joy, but the energy of anxiety and confusion. What does this surprising discovery mean? Of the three people mentioned in the gospel reading this morning, the evangelist declares that only one of them recognized immediately why the tomb was empty. It was the beloved disciple who saw and believed. He recognized that the reason the tomb was empty was not because the body had been stolen, but because Jesus had risen from the dead. Having been put to death by human powers, he had been raised to new life by God's power. This is what the beloved disciple recognized. This was Easter faith. This is the faith which brings us together on this Easter Sunday. So we gather to celebrate the good news that the crucified Jesus is now the risen Lord. Just as Jesus was faithful to God and to the mission God had given him, faithful unto death, God, in turn, was faithful to Jesus, bringing him through death into a new and glorious life. That was good news for Jesus, but it is also good news for all of us. It's because God raised Jesus from the dead to a new and more powerful life, then Jesus is now not just a figure of history belonging to the past. Rather, he is more alive today than he was before he was put to death. In being raised from the dead, Jesus did not return to the life he lived before his death. He passed over into a fuller and more wonderful life, a life which allows him to be powerfully present to his followers of every generation. So the Jesus who walked the paths of Galilee and the streets of Jerusalem continues to journey with all of us as risen Lord. This was the wonderful discovery that the two disciples made as they journeyed from Jerusalem to Emmaus. The Jesus who had been crucified continued to walk with them as one who had been transformed, gloriously changed. He continued to be present to them in a special way in the scriptures and in the Eucharist.
their hearts burnt within them as he opened the scriptures for them, and then went on to recognize him fully in the breaking of the bread. The scriptures and the Eucharist remain two privileged ways that the risen Lord is present to us today. He continues to speak to us through his word, so that our hearts might burn within us, so that our faith may be fanned into a living faith or flame. He continues. He continues to give himself to us in the Eucharist under the form of bread and wine, just as he first gave himself to his disciples under the form of bread and wine at the Last Supper, in anticipation of the gift of himself to them and to all the following day on the cross. So as the Lord continues to give himself to us in the Eucharist, we are invited like the two disciples on the road to Emmaus to recognize him in the Eucharist. Apart from those privileged places where the Lord draws near to us, his word and the Eucharist, the risen Lord is present to us in many other ways as well. So the Lord also comes to us in and through those he termed the least of his brothers and sisters, those who are most vulnerable and who seem to have least to offer. One of the lines in this Easter sequence that we read before today's gospel reading goes, "Christ, my hope, has risen. He goes before you into Galilee." We can substitute Galilee with North Adams or any place name we choose and live. The Lord is always going before us and coming towards us. Today's wonderful feast assures us that the Lord is all around us, even in those dark and difficult experiences that threaten and swamp and engulf us. He is all around us as we face into that most difficult experience of our own death. As one who has passed through death to a new life, he will take us through death to a sharing in his one risen life. If we remain in communion with him. I like how St. Paul puts it, that very simply, Christ is your life. The Lord first gives us a share in his risen life at baptism. So in this liturgy, right after my homily, we will renew our baptismal promises and be sprinkled with the holy water. So then at the hour of our death, we will be brought fully into his risen life. And that is the hope given to us by this wonderful feast of Easter. Amen. Please rise. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we've been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and his works, and promised to serve God and the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan and all his works and all his empty show? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death, and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestow on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen.
Hope and the power of his resurrection fills the world today with new life, with hope and expectation. We therefore bring him all our needs and prayers.
For the church in this season of joy, may the Holy Spirit empower us to share the good news with all. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who serve in the judicial system and in law enforcement, may the Lord guide them in the ways of justice and peace. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who do not yet believe or understand, may the light of the risen Christ draw them to faith and truth. Let us pray to the Lord. For all of us gathered here, may we be drawn more deeply into personal relationships with Christ through his loving power. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who have died in the hope of the resurrection, may they rest in eternal peace in God's heavenly kingdom. And today we remember in a special way the Blessed Virgin Mary. Let us pray to the Lord. And for any special petitions you have, could you please say them in the silence of your hearts? Let us pray to the Lord.
And we pray that in the light of Christ's victory over death, nations may work together to overcome war, violence against all, especially the poor, the weak, and the unborn. As we say to our Mother Mary, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. God of glory, you know the deepest desires of our hearts. As we celebrate the resurrection, make us faithful to you in all we do, and we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn is number 542, Sing to the Mountains.
Bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life. There's a chalice in the sacristy, if you could drink. Yes. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, will become our spiritual bread. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord our God. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer this sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day, above all, to love you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are filled with your glory. Hosanna.
you are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." In song, let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, William, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from you. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Peace of Christ be with you. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Please join me in reciting prayer to St. Michael. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Friends, again, happy Easter Sunday of the resurrection of the Lord. Jesus has risen from the dead, and this announcement resounds in the church throughout the world. Together with the singing of Alleluia, he is alive forever in our midst. Now, this is good news. This good news has been lit like a new flame in the holy night of Easter Vigil, which we celebrated yesterday, and the night of a world that faces crucial challenges due to wars in Ukraine and Palestine and all the trials that hinder the life of humanity. Now, today we must be grateful and thankful, because we are able to, together as a family, to celebrate our Lord's resurrection. And that is the reason for our joy. A joy that has come, that has to become contagious, because it has to make us lose fear. And as a parish, in the midst of this Easter joy, I want to invite you so that this Easter celebration is reflected in our faith commitment and in the increase of our love for the parish. And finally, I would like to thank all the volunteers of our parish, our musicians. Thank you, Matthew, for your presence and beautiful music. To Amy and Patsy, lectors, extraordinary ministers, sacristans, musicians, instrumentalists, all who in communion with parish staff have made a great effort so that the liturgy of these special days of Holy Week were all done beautifully and with great respect. Know that you are all very important to me and have a very important place in my heart. So, happy Easter Sunday of the resurrection of the Lord. God bless you. Let us pray. Look upon your church, O Lord, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. And may the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia. Alleluia. To God, alleluia, alleluia. Have a blessed Easter.
Please join us in our recessional hymn, number 180. Alleluia, alleluia, let the holy anthem rise.
Alleluia.